Hi, Stan with 3D PT. So I'm starting on a project to start printing cement on a desktop printer. There are a couple printers that will print in clays, but my long-term goal for this is to start printing full-size houses. So Thomas Hutton designed what's called the LVE Large Volume Extruder, which was designed to bioprint like organs in a gel matrix. And when I saw his design for a modification for his printer, I realized I could convert that easily, should be able to convert that easily to print cement. So this video is going to be the first part of that, where I cover the assembly of what I've done so far and some of the modifications I've done as well. So this is the whole core here. The motor turns this large gear. So for this, this is called the LVE system. First thing I did is I made a base plate to mount it to the top of the Taz 5. This is the LVE core. I modified this again so I could bolt on this plate. I also cut out a slot here. On the original, you would have to have had to unscrew everything to put it in and out every single time. I'm probably going to be doing a lot of changes, so I just made this so it would pop in and out. This is the shuttle that articulates the plunger, and you put your cement in here. And on the end of this, there's going to be a hose. So I've got some refrigerator hosing that's used for like the water line and fridges. This way it's food safe, so I could also print food if I want. And large gear is connected to the motor up here. This is just a standard step motor. And the idea is, as this turns, it moves forward and back. And it's just, it is very fine. So the second video I'm going to make is going to be how to do all the step settings and everything for this. The modifications and the core and everything I'm going to post once I have a working printer. So this is just going to be the first step where I articulate everything. Now with this modification, you turn your Taz 5 from a direct drive to a Bowden system. So if you imagine the hose coming out to here, it's also going to come to this piece. And so this is the standard X carriage holder for the Taz 5 tool head. You can download that from the Lulzbot site, and I'll provide a link to that in the blog. And I just modified this, the idea being I could take the nozzle. There's a couple thumb screws, which you'll see actually closer in this video. Designed this to be quick changing. So the nozzle comes out here with the hose, tightened down by a plate with these thumb screws. And this whole assembly actually comes out with another set of thumb screws here. Again, the idea is I'm probably going to have to make some changes to this head. I designed it to be the same length as a standard tool head from a Taz 5. That way I don't have to change the Z offsets for the printer. I don't have to reset my machine major a lot if I decide to go back and forth. And this is a 5/8 refrigerator line. And the idea is this little bit of the tube will stick out and be the final nozzle. That way, if it's worn away, I could just cut it off. Alright, for this, I modified the core. So I put a set of holes on the top to go all the way through to the bottom. And this way you could go through and you could screw in and mount the mounting bracket for the Taz 5. And this, I think, is a 2.5 millimeter Allen key. My first version, it was just at the wrong angle to get to that, so it made bolting that on hard. And so this is the mounting plate, and this is the LVE core. And this will mount to the top of the Taz 5 with everything else going out of it. Okay, this is the shuttle piece that goes in here and moves back and forth, and it moves this plunger. Now, a problem I found is that the plunger tends to warp here at the corner. despite my best efforts. And the way you print this is flat like this, so you have a lot of support material here. I may play around with that in the future. But inside also the shuttle piece here, you can see there's a ridge, and that's supposed to match up really tightly with this, but if your piece isn't the best printed or fast printed, you might have to, I'm going to go in with the Dremel and just sand that edge down, because the idea behind this is that this shuttle piece is supposed to fit in there, and this articulates back and forth to press on the syringe. So I'm going to have to spend some quality time with the Dremel. Alright, for the nut shuttle, again, getting the nut to fit here in the back. Thomas Hinton has two nuts and then a back plate that screws on. And the idea is this is gives you some flexibility and is supposed to take out some play. Well, I had such a problem getting the nut to fit in by itself, so what I did is I actually put this in hot water, and that expanded the plastic and softened it up a bit. And then I just shoved the, I did have the nut on ice for a little bit, and so the combination of shrinking and expanding actually also softened up the plastic. So I was able to actually just press fit it in, and right now it's not going to come out. This goes in here. And the screw rod turns and moves this back and forth. So inside the nut shuttle, to put the back plate on, there's a 3M3 by 0.5 cap screws, 3M3 nuts, and the main nut inside is an M8 by 1.25. And so here's the whole thing assembled. You can see the M8 nut inside and the 3M3 nuts. These I actually had to press fit with a pair of pliers and then just tap them in with a hammer. Once you put this together, it's very snug, and so this will definitely help going back and forth. Here's completed assembly. So for the gear here, get some light on that. This actually was tight enough to thread straight onto it. So for right now, I'm just going to do that and secure it with my. I ended up running out of these M8 by 1.25s nuts. So you'll need 2, 4, 6 of them. I found when you go to the hardware store. Problem in the U.S. is that these are usually sold in like packs of two, and somehow I just ended up short. So I'll look around, but for right now it's fine. Mounted the motor here and make sure it meshes with the big gear, and so this will turn. So let me put it on the end here. And it is fairly slow, which is good because you'll want a steady pressure. And so my next challenge is going to be wiring. This is a standard step motor. And the way this meshes together, this green wheel actually has a rim to it. And so it's supposed to be kept like this. If you watch the Hinton video, he actually points out that this gear, herringbone gear, goes forward. And when it does that, it extrudes. And if it goes this way, then it is retracting. And the strength of this system is that it can retract fluid, which is actually going to be valuable if you want to do like door posts or windows in your cement model. So here's everything assembled. The plunger goes here on the syringe. It's going to go inside the plunger. So if you imagine this filled, Then it locks in here. On this end. And this end also goes into the shuttle here. And the idea is as it goes forward, squirts out your stuff here. And on this end, I still have to adapt it to fit a bigger tubing, because Hinton's design is designed for very fine work, and using alginate that actually adapts. This is a Luger lock syringe. This is, what is it? I think this is a 5/16 refrigerator tubing. I got this because one of the things I like to test is actually doing something like peanut butter with this. So this is food grade refrigerator tubing. And the challenge will be next to adapt it to the syringe. So I'm probably going to have to drill out the little nozzle that's in there and probably just end up epoxying this in for right now. This is a 60 milliliter Luger lock syringe. It's one of the biggest ones you could get on the market. They use this in hospitals for irrigation and general treatment. You could actually get a case of them for case of 40 for, I think it's about $15. Now to glue it, I still have to cut off the plunger tip off the standard one, glue it to this. So the next challenge, I have a couple more challenges ahead. One, getting the tubing to work. Second, I'm going to take that tubing and run it through this nozzle. So I found these thumb screws when I was shopping. And this way, what I want to do is have a quick change system, so in case the tubing collapses, I could just pull it out of this. And I'm probably going to have to get this to fit, but the idea is that this is your nozzle here. Now, I actually modified this so it would fit on the same carriage as the standard tool head and have the same hot end length. So if I compare them side by side here, this way, I don't have to change out from a standard tool head. I don't have to change the Z offset or anything. I should be able to just drop this in, make a little fine adjustment on the Z to start printing. I think height-wise, I'm going to start at maybe about, with cement, it's going to have to be something like 600 micron up to about 1.2 millimeter layer height. So the nice thing is, pretty much all I did is I took the carriage piece and the bottom part of the standard tool head off the Taz 5, and I modified that to work with the nozzle like this. And this changes your printer from a direct drive to a Bowden drive system. So I don't need all this heavy stuff here. And pretty much with the main motor being on top here, this is just going to go back and forth and position the cement for extruding. So that's what I'm hoping to do. And again, my next step is going to be the wiring. I do have a spare Lulzbot motor that already has the wiring pins in it. The one I put on was a loose motor I had from another project. So I'm kind of debating what to do with that. But I think for right now, I'm going to work on the tubing and the motor wiring. To attach the gear to the motor, the small gear, Hinton uses M3x16s. Those are actually too shallow for me to get in, so I just switch up to M3x20s. So those won't stick out too much. And the motor is going to go up here. And so, yeah. So everything is in place now. So next thing I'm going to do is stick the motor here, and then I'll film the last step, try and film the last step to get the main gear on.
Three, two, one.
All right, thank you for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and hit subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. The second part of this video, or a second video, I'm going to try and get the programming down to do the steps correctly to extrude it. I'm also going to work on cement mixes. You do have to have something about the consistency of toothpaste for this to work. If you want to learn more, in the link below, there'll be a link to the blog about the first part of this, and then the second blog will also go into more depth about how I assembled this LVE core. Thank you for watching.